being able to integrate charging systems, you know, such as the power buoys that we have, you can now go and end up with all sizes and all endurances and all types of payloads and speeds being able to deploy it almost anywhere. You know, you could imagine a system where you have a whole bunch of forward deployed permanent sentinels.
Hello, you're watching Proactive. I'm joined by Ocean Power Technology CEO Philipp Stratmann. Philipp, very good to speak with you. How do you see this newly awarded patent transforming OPT's commercial opportunities in the offshore energy and autonomy markets?
Yeah, Stephen, it's great to be on. We're super excited about this patent. If you think about the opportunities this opens up in the ocean technology space in general, there's obviously lots of talk and a lot of excitement in the industry in general, and probably I think a lot of public attention on USVs and ASVs and just generally autonomous systems. But it's a little bit like the early days of electric vehicles onshore and on land. It's great, you've got them, but what do you do with it when you run out of battery juice? So the ability to have chargers that we can start deploying out in the ocean, so that, you know, autonomous systems can come alongside, re-top up their batteries, extricate the data so that somebody else can run and use that data in, you know, whatever AI system they might be running to do ocean exploration and ocean sensing. I think it's very exciting. And the fact that I've been able to do this based on the skill set that we have in-house just shows that, you know, we continue to innovate, and it's an exciting time to be in this space.
Can you explain how the integration of the floating charging station with PowerBuoy and WAM-V will improve mission endurance for your defense and commercial clients, perhaps revolutionizing the industry?
Yeah, so if you're looking currently at the world of autonomous systems, you know, you have two extremes. You have long duration, but generally lower speed or lower payload, or you have shorter endurance, but higher payload, higher speed type systems. But being able to integrate charging systems, you know, such as the power buoys that we have, you can now go and end up with all sizes and all endurances and all types of payloads and speeds being able to deploy it almost anywhere. You know, you could imagine a system where you have a whole bunch of forward deployed permanent sentinels that are telling you what's going on in an area of interest. That could be a border. It could be around national security. It could be about mammal protection. It could be about offshore energy security. And now, once you detect something on your sentinels, you can now dispatch from one of these, you know, future docking and staging systems a autonomous vehicle that can go out and collect additional data, maybe be able to interdict or intercept or take action upon what you've observed. So I think that is a complete step change in the way that the ocean industry could work.
What steps are you taking to commercialize this integrated product? And are there any near-term pilot deployments planned with partners or government agencies?
Yeah, we did a high-fidelity prototype here just off the coast of New Jersey in Raritan Bay off New York City last summer. And we're currently working on the commercialization of these efforts. We've got various vehicles deployed all over the world that have been pushed out there. I think you saw last week, you know, we were working on some NATO exercises out in the Baltic. Equally, we've got, you know, buoys being installed all around the world. And I think the ability to combine the two of them and us working on taking what we did last year as a prototype into a fully commercially available solution is something that our team is working on right now. So I think we're looking forward to discussing this further with our customers and starting to look at where the first commercial rollouts are going to happen.
Philipp, given the importance of intellectual property in your sector, how does this patent fit into OPT's broader innovation strategy and IP portfolio growth?
Yeah, we like to patent things that we think are absolutely crucial and critical. We don't go out there and patent absolutely everything our team comes across. But I think this is one of those key integrated pieces that we think is critical to differentiate OPT from a commercialization perspective to others in the industry. You know, we collaborate very well with a whole bunch of other companies and entities. And we think this gives us the opportunity to continue scaling on the things that we know we're good at. and equally protecting that intellectual property as we roll this out globally, and in return help our investors and shareholders generate the returns they're looking for.
Well, congratulations again on that patent, and thank you very much for speaking with us today.
No, I appreciate it. Great to be on. Thanks, Stephen.
You're very welcome. Philipp Stratmann, CEO of Ocean Power Technologies.